seaweed.
We've got serrated rack here, which is quite nice, just deep fried. A good bit, there's a good bit. What excites me about this food is that it hasn't travelled thousands of miles like the sort of thing you might find in a supermarket. So the distance from food to plate is hardly anything.
It's really not something that would appeal to me.
Of course, what I would say to that would be, it's better to have your salt from a natural source like this than have it packed into food after every other nutrient's been washed out of it. But do you reckon you'll try some today? Fingers cracking, the answer.
Okay, then I'll give it a bit. Okay. Only a little tiny bit, though.
Fantastic. A little tiny bit. Let's do it.
To prove that his wild food can be quick and easy, they head back to Rob's.
How long does your thing take to cook?
Well, mine's about 9 minutes.
So, let's go.
It's microwaved macaroni cheese versus seaweed with a giant puffball mushroom omelette.
Pick off the best bits.
Just under 7.5 minutes, so there's 1.5 minutes gone now.
Do I look worried? If you're not used to eating seaweed, this one's quite good to introduce it with something you're a bit more familiar with, like some tomatoes. Tiny bit of water.
You've got about 6 minutes left now.
So, a couple of eggs.
Just under 3 minutes left. I still think it's a lot of work for something that's gonna not be as good as mine.
The word you're looking for is delightfully and tastily different. It's omelette with giant puffball mushroom and chickweed.
Still think you're going to actually make it?
Yeah, no problem.
Oh, you got 30 seconds.
Shit. The omelette's sticking.
Well, that's mine ready, but we do have a minute for it to cool down a bit.
Well, how do you like your omelette? I like mine au beurre, which is slightly moist. If that's the case, then your omelette's done and your meal's ready. There's your sea beet, your wild spinach. There's your tomato, seaweed. Right, omelette's ready.
Both meals took 9 minutes, but will Fergus's puffball mushroom omelette, served with wild spinach and seaweed, win on the taste front?
All right. That's really nice. I am quite surprised, actually. Yeah, I haven't tried the seaweed yet, so... It's different. It's actually not too bad.
What do you think of the wild spinach? Because I know you told me you like spinach.
Yeah, I do like spinach. I actually like the seaweed the most, I think.
Magic words.
I don't know why. I shouldn't, but I do.
You should, believe me. Your body is telling you this is fantastic.
Mm. It's actually really nice. What do you think of my one?
For me, for my taste, this is so incredibly salty.
Which is strange, because I imagine the seaweed to be really salty. Mm. To me, I don't think it's got anything in it at all now.
Can you taste the salt in here?
Doesn't taste very nice at all after you've been eating this.
That's enough for me. Where is the green? Where's the vegetable? Where's the nutrients? And I just want to go...
You expect everything to come from a supermarket. You think it's going to be... Well, you imagine it's going to be sort of fresher and cleaner and... But I'm surprised. I really am quite surprised. It is really nice.
Mm. He admitted it looked better and... And he couldn't argue with the fact that it hadn't taken long to do. So I was really excited and really happy about that.
I suppose it's made me think that maybe you can actually cook quite quickly and do something that's actually quite decent rather than something that's just quick and easy out of a packet.
That's where I am. Fergus. Hey. Fergus the Forager. So I'm kind of halfway through this process and I'm finding that it is quite interesting, quite easy, in fact, to engage people on the subject of wild food and seasonality in terms of sourcing your vegetables and stuff. But that's one thing to say, hey, we know all about it, but to actually go and do that and make that part of your lifestyle, even in a little way, it's a much bigger step. That's me, Fergus the Forager.
Fergus has only been in Sandwich for 10 days, and already he's causing quite a stir. It's time to start advertising for his wild food feast, and by law, Fergus can't charge guests to eat roadkill, so the feast will be completely free.
Fergus the Forager invites you to dinner. I'm the wild man and I love wild food. I have a dream. I want to get you, the people of Sandwich, thinking about what you eat and, through eating forage food, get you back in touch with nature.
Around the homes of Sandwich, people who bumped into him are chatting about Fergus and what he stands for.
How are you supposed to know if that sort of thing's safe to eat? Like, it could be poisonous or something and you could die.
So does he never go shopping? Does he pick everything? Does he?
When it says roadkill, is that just like any kind of animal that's been run over?
Well, I'm guessing it's like a dead cat.
Well, yeah, exactly. That's what I was thinking, like a dead cat or a dog.
I wouldn't mind eating a cat. A dog I won't touch.
You wouldn't mind eating a cat? Are you kidding me?
Is there not much of a difference between eating a cow and eating a rabbit? They're all animals.
For Fergus to really get the message across and change a whole town's eating habits, he needs to convince the teenagers.
Often they're influenced by, like, peer pressure to, like, eat crap food and stuff. If you can win someone over at the kind of teenage years, so it's quite notoriously difficult age, then I think you can win lots of people over.
It's Fergus's biggest test yet. He's speaking at a local school to an assembly of 300 11 to 18 year olds.
Foraging is really about rebellion. It's about rebelling against standardisation. It's about rebelling against processed, flavourless food. It's about rebelling against the fact that we're rushing around these days so fast that we're disconnected from our food, where it comes from our local environment. So foraging for me is about radically connecting with the environment, which is often stuck in front of the television, playing our computer games. We've really lost something.
Today, school dinner is off the menu. Instead, it's wild food with Fergus.
First thing is nettle soup. Then, for dessert, I've made a seaweed dessert, it's a set blancmange, and I hope I can win them over with the sharpness and the colours, which I think are quite amazing. You're not so sure.
Well, we will wait and see.
With not much time, Fergus prepares the stinging nettles.
What is quite difficult is some of the colours of the wild food. It's so raw, it's so natural. You know, those dark greens, they might think, ugh! You know, the last time they saw anything like that was, you know, when they were thrown into the nearest slimy pond. Oh my God. They've all arrived already. It's going to be ready in literally about 5 minutes.
Fergus's soup is a blend of stinging nettles, potatoes, and milk.
Right, soup's just coming. I'm really pleased they're eager. Who's up for nettle soup? It's nettle soup. Very nutritious, very good for you. Yeah, stinging nettles.
Down it
in one. Go.
Who wants some?
You want some what?
I've got it on there.
Shall I have another one, sir?
It's just weird. The way it kind of looks and smell. You would think it's not nice, but then when you actually...
It doesn't really taste like nettles.
Like... OK, the dessert is... It's a blancmange made with milk, vanilla, a little bit of sugar, and a secret ingredient, which sets the milk. Any ideas?